Today's product is another AI tool built on top of GPT-3 and propriety. What they are highlighting about themselves is that they are generating the absolute best content in the industry of AI tools. Whether that's true or not, we'll find out in the testing phase, because I will show you a lot of these tools that today's product showcase offer. Today's tool that I've taken a look at is called Rytr. It's a very simple tool and their communication is to the point. They don't have a ton of integrations and a huge company structure around. They have the tools and that's about it. They have 5,000 users and 25 different use cases for their tools. So without further ado, let's dive into Rytr and test out their tools. When we take a look at Rytr, this is the view that you see. You can see it's very simple. We don't have a menu with a lot of menu points. This is what you get. This is the overall generation tool where we can choose the language we want that the output of the content is in. And they have at the moment 19 languages and they are continuously adding more. One thing to notice that's really differing Rytr from the competitors is the tone. Try to see how many different tones they have. It's great to see because this is something I haven't seen before and I have tested it out and there are differences in the way that the content is, so it's definitely working. The last thing down here is the use cases. This is basically the tools they have. They are adding more all the time and they are reworking them, but at the moment they have around 25 tools, as you can see right here. If we go over to account, we have how our credits are being used. Then we have our profile, of course, and then the rewards in here. If you want more credits, if you're on the free plan, for instance, then you can get, for instance, 1,000 credits just for sharing on LinkedIn or Facebook or Twitter. That's 3,000 credits right here to generate even more content. Furthermore, here, if you add reviews, you will get more credits and so much more. This is just so great. Of course, they have their affiliate program where you can earn a commission and then FAQs. Overall, I have to say that their communication is great. That's something that they're really excelling on. But if we try to test out some of their tools, let's say that we want the output language to be English, and I will take the tool blog article idea and outline. For the keywords, let's type in. So I chose the blog article idea and outline. So here I both get an idea and I get an outline. I chose the keywords WooCommerce templates for webshops on a budget. Here I can choose whether I want multiple variants or I just want one variant. For this case, I just chose one variant. And here you can see that we get a title and we get an outline basically. Here they show us the 5 different themes, except for the last one, which is basically just a general title, static free WooCommerce theme. That's not a specific theme, but it could be a title somehow. When I take a look at this, I think the outline is okay. I would like it to add maybe an introduction in the beginning. And then we have the 4 themes here that we can go through. Definitely a great idea. Then I would remove this one and then add a conclusion in the end. And I think this is great. I think this is great to get started. And we have our title here that now says 5 WooCommerce templates your webshop needs. But it's overall okay. And of course, I would have to change this one to 4. But what's also cool is the write more thing here, because now I will show you how we just generate long form content in steps. So we choose the blog article intro and content, and then basically I'll just enter down here for a new line. And now you can see that I have to give it a topic in order for this to generate more content for me. So for instance, let's take this storefront theme and then just add a little bit text to it. So I have now added my topic and I will now press write for me. And what we will see in a second is that it's gonna add some sections based on the topic I gave it right here. So as you can see here, it has now added some text based on the topic that I gave it. However, when I take a look at the text generated, I must say that I'm a bit disappointed. It has nothing to do with the storefront theme. And even though I mention storefront and theme in the same sentence, it still goes to describe something about self-funding and bootstrapping a company and entrepreneurs and bootstrapping and so much more. This content is just useless for me in this context. But let's try another test. Let's try and delete everything here and then just take the title that Rytr gave to me myself and then just add it here and say write for me. So here you can see it has now generated some content. However, again, I'm not a big fan of this content generated. It's talking very generic about WooCommerce templates or e-commerce websites in this case. And it's talking about that we're offering some WooCommerce themes and so on. The content is okay. It's not what I'm looking for exactly. The tone is definitely convincing. If we take a look at the last section down here where it's trying to sell some web design services for $99. But overall, this blog article content tool is not that refined, if you ask me. But now let's try some of the other tools that Rytr offers. Let's, for instance, try the video description for a YouTube video. And let's try and see if it can generate some content for a specific product. So I've now entered some text based on active campaign as a video. I've chosen three variants in this case. But one thing to notice here, which I also mentioned in my previous videos, is that content tools with a limit here makes it more difficult to be more precise. And we need to be precise in order to generate the best possible content. So this is not a positive thing if you ask me. But let's try and test out the video description for ActiveCampaign, the best tool if you want to automate your marketing. So the content generated here is actually great. It's talking about that ActiveCampaign is great if you want to save time and money, and it's an email marketing tool. That's cool, that's very, very good. However, there are only two variants generated. I asked for three, but based on this, I can only see two variants. Let's try and change the tone to be a little bit more casual, and then let's see how the output is going to be. So here I actually got three variants, which is great. The first section is a lot like the previous one, but it is changed, and you can see that it's talking about its interface, their features overall. So this is a bit more casual, it's a bit more general. And then we have the second section, which is also great, and the third section also great. So for video descriptions, it is a bit short. Of course, I can combine these and then get a longer description, but this tool is definitely working better than the tool we just tested for the blog intro and the blog content overall. Now, my native language is Danish, so I can't really test out other languages, but you can see that the different languages here is what you can get the output in. If I, for instance, choose Portuguese and I try and write for me, then we'll get the output in actual Portuguese, as you will see in a moment. So as you can see right here, we got the output out and it's now in Portuguese. I cannot confirm whether this content is great or not, as I don't understand Portuguese, but this is to show you how fast and easy it is to get content in different languages. As the last tool I want to show you is their landing page description. Of course, they have a lot more tools as you just saw, but let's try and get a description for our landing page. So first of all, the tool name I'm not a big fan of because a landing page is not needing a description. A landing page needs a lot of text, a lot of sections. So the way Rytsonic did it, if you didn't see that, you can go back and see that video where I show how Rytsonic does it, because they really does it in a great way. And they also add a design for you to get an idea of how the content is working. But let's try and add some content here and see how the landing page description works. So a landing page is usually containing a lot of content. Here I can only write 75 characters and I hit that limit after 10 seconds of writing. So this is a huge, huge minus in order for me to generate content for the landing page. So as you can see here, again, it's generated in Portuguese. Just for you to see, I will now generate some English. So a cool thing it does here is that it works with variables, which means that everywhere where it says brand name, we can of course put in our brand name. And as you see here, when it is that I highlight something, I can either try to shorten it, rephrase it, append it, a paragraph, or expand it. And this is also part of the tools in here. So this is definitely a cool small feature that can enhance your workflow overall. But the text generated are okay. They are very, very small and very short in the text description. And when it's a landing page, we need long and we need a lot of different sections. So overall, this tool I don't find so relevant for me to use at least. The last thing I want to show you is their document section here. Here you will have all the content that you have generated and you will have it in an overview here for you to easily find what it is you need. So you will always have this view where you have the documents or the content on the right side and the tools on the left side. And last thing is that if you don't like this view, you can also open it up in full screen here. And then this is what you will see. Again, you will have the tools on the left and the documents on the right. It's basically the same view, just in a full screen. So yeah, as you can see, the content generated is sometimes good, sometimes not so good. For the video tool, it was very good. For the landing page, it was too short, but it was precise. And for the blog intro and content, it was just not relevant enough. So as I will also talk about in a minute, their comparisons to their competitors, I wouldn't say are reliable at this moment. When it comes to Rytr's pricing structure, it is very simple, which also aligns it with their entire communication. They have two plans. They have their free plan where you get 5,000 characters that you can generate each month, which is very generous. And then they have their premium plan where you can generate as much content as you want. You have unlimited characters. Furthermore, they allow rewards for you. So let's say that you are on the free plan and you want more credits and more characters in order to generate more content. Well, then you can share them on Twitter, or you can make a review on Captera or something like that. That will give you characters in return for you to generate even more content. When we take a look at their competitors, they do compare themselves to almost any AI tool out there. But if you ask me, I see them very similar to Niches and Rytsonic. Even though Niches and Rytsonic has a lot more tools to offer, then Rytr do generate some good content. But they don't have integrations, and they don't have webhooks, and they don't have a WordPress plugin. So where does this put them? It is something they're looking into in the future, but they are more focused on the tools right now as it is. When we take a look at their future, they're working on a plagiarism checker and a browser extension. This browser extension we have seen at other companies, and what it makes is that it makes it possible for you to generate content wherever you are on the web. So let's say you need to write a review, you need to answer a question, or you need to just make a comment. Well, with a browser extension, it's possible for you to generate an answer within seconds, and all you have to do is just plug in some keywords. Furthermore, they're working on just optimizing their tools overall. And they're also working on adding more tools like an image tool where you can generate images based on keywords, and an SEO tool where you can optimize your entire article or your long form content based on the keywords that you put in. Furthermore, they are also helping you based on your content to fetch the tags that will be good for you to use both for your content, but also for your Twitter and for your social media profiles in general. Overall, I counted more than 16 tools that they're going to add in the future. And another cool thing is that they're adding a feedback system. This we have seen in almost all the other tools, because this is a great way for them to be in direct contact with their users. And the users, when they generate content, can then tell based on the content, was it good or was it bad? And Rytr can use this feedback in order to improve their tools. So it's definitely a win-win for everyone here. Rytr has made comparisons to almost any AI tools out there. The problem is that they have added grades, but they don't explain how these grades are made. They have just added it to make Rytr look better than any tool out there. So I don't feel that I can trust these comparisons, and it's definitely why I tested out the tool to see whether the comparisons were true or not. Rytr is without a doubt a very simple application where you get the tools that you need and you generate the content. As you saw in my features, it is that, and you get only that. So if you're looking for a tool where you can integrate with all the other tools that you're using, or just do more and have different tools, Rytr is not for you. However, if you are completely new to the AI game and you're just looking for a tool where you can start generating content, I would definitely recommend you taking a look at Rytr. So yeah, that's my review of Rytr, a very simple AI tool. I hope that you liked the video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. And if you have any questions about Rytr or other products you would like me to review, please leave a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. Let's catch up on the next one.